Hi, my friends. I'm Luca Turilli, composer of Rhapsody, and you are enjoying Spark TV Metal in Action. Ciao, see you soon.
Spark TV Metal in Action.
All right, hey, what's up? You are watching Spark TV Metal in Action, and today I'm very proud to welcome maestro of guitars. That's Luca Turilli, big composer. Hi, Luca.
Hi, my friends. It's a pleasure to be here with you.
Okay, so I think it's very simple to ask you how it is going on with Prometheus on tour.
Well, it's fantastic. You know, as I always say, first great thing is when you compose in your studio like that. But then the second greatest thing for a composer is to hear your music on stage and to feel the contact with the people. So it's just amazing to meet all our fans all around Europe, especially tonight in Czech Republic.
Spark TV. Metal in Action.
You said that it was something like restart for you. Well, once again, how hard was it for you?
No, absolutely not hard. No, because we have anyway our Rhapsody fan base, and so it was not that difficult, of course. No, keeping the name, all that. There was the friendly split with my ex-colleague of Rhapsody of Fire. So in the end, it was not that hard, no? It was not like to change the name, to start from zero. You have to know that after the split, I was not even supposed to go on with Rhapsody. At the time, my project was to create something in the Avantasia way, no? With many famous singers, all that. There was a big plan for it, no? But then when I searched for a singer, a main singer, no? Where around, to build this Avantasia project around him, and it happened that I met Alessandro Conti, our actor singer. Then in the end I said, "Ma, this guy is perfect really also to, for me to go on with as a Rhapsody."
Už brzy můžeš na Spark TV vyhrát nové album Rhapsody Prometheus podepsané Lukou Turillim a k tomu 3 Rhapsody trsátka. Sleduj Spark TV.
Spark TV. Metal in Action.
Still you are composing for movies.
Yeah, you know, we had to restart from zero also in that case, because when you have a name, let's say in the heavy metal, then it's not that automatically you are known also in the Hollywood, in the Hollywood scene. So yes, we had to make a demo. I have one partner, Ali Morgan, who worked already with bands like U2, Taylor Swift, so big pop heads act, let's say, and is a mixer and mixer. So we found, we created this kind of company, no, partnership. And we had to write a demo, like in the early times for Rhapsody, and then we found an agent. But then in Hollywood, you know, it's different because they ask you to create like 30, 40 pieces in different styles of music. And then with this music, they go to shop to their clients, not these agents, to find the right place where to put your. It's not like the same with Rhapsody, no? With Rhapsody, it's something else. People know that I wrote the music. It's something, no? You feel more, it's like the product of your heart and soul. What for me, Rhapsody is about mainly, no? This is the more that most important aspect, I would say, of making music with Rhapsody. Speak through heart and soul. It's not something made for money. Because if I would like to make music for money, I would do something in the style of David Guetta or something like that.
Really?
I mean, you know, I, as a composer, I know all the music. Okay. So I could compose music from, I don't know, probably the only music I'm not able to compose is if you constrict me to write for drums, guitars, bass, a voice alone.
Spark TV. Metal in Action.
You decided for something kind of science fiction, we can say, some modern science fiction, we can say. Just why? Because I think this is a next step for you from, we can say, from fantasy to science fiction.
No, I would not say like that. I would say all the lyrics were always filled with metaphysical stuff. That is what really interests me. You know, I'm a particular guy. I met Alex Taropoli in the, I don't remember, 1991, something like that, at a course of mind dynamics, no? To empower, to learn how to empower the mind possibilities, something like that, no? To stimulate the brain in particular ways, all that, no? So I was always interested in this kind of metaphysical stuff where material world and spiritual world in some way get in touch, no? And so, even in, also in the saga, why I chose the Emerald Sword, I already told it on Facebook in some articles that I wrote, that people find very interesting, so then I like to explain even more. For example, we chose the Emerald because of the Emerald Tablet of Hermes Trismegistus, no? Corpus Hermeticum, all that stuff. I was always interested in those secret codes, these things, including a lot of truths, no? Explaining a lot of our universe, of our stuff. So I would say the ancient knowledge, no? Transposed in the modern times. And with Rhapsody, is this what I try to do, no? I tried also in the saga, in the 10 albums of the saga, to fill the stories with these elements, no? So you could have read the saga in a superficial way, like the normal story, like a movie, like Lord of the Rings, or find some inner, deeper, much deeper meanings.
Spark TV. Metal in action.
Are you interested in this world, how it is, everything happened in Europe with refugees and so on? Do you see some changes in Italy?
You know, I see always the typical things that happen in the, no, in this political. That's why I don't believe in politics. I never voted. I'm really nothing. You know, I'm really nothing. Like they say, the Tibetan, nothing to be everything. No, in the end, you can be everything only if you are nothing before. No, if you say I'm this, I'm for that because I'm against this, I'm for this. The important is that the fact is that the people now, they express judgment without knowing the facts, no? We don't know the facts, we just know what the news on the television say. And so all the people then, based on their experience, based on their spiritual level, consciousness level, I would say, they decide, I like this, no, I don't like that. So I don't like even to give a judgment about this. This is a problem that have to be known before. I don't know all the aspects, so I cannot really give a judgment. So when I know everything, I see with my eyes, I see with my heart, then I can really understand which is the problem.
Maybe that's why you are so positive.
No, yes, I don't know why, you know, I've also the episode in 1993 of the cancer, the doctors telling to me there is no chance, not to me, to my mother at the time, of course. You know, I had to make this chemotherapy, they say the doctor, you know, we think there is nothing to do really, but we can try to make this chemotherapy, but will be very heavy, and maybe he will die just because of that, no? But they tried, and then the miracle happened, a real miracle, because I was full of metastasis, no? That's why I say to all the people that are in the same situation, that seem the doctor say there is nothing to do, or things like that, just concentrate, focus on light, on really the positivity, that, you know? And then you can make miracles, because there is a part of light in each one of us. We are all connected, so it's not that we have to expect miracles from the external. We can make the miracle from the inside, no?
It was the message for the end, that you have to believe in light, in something that brings light. So Luca, thank you so much. Thank you so much to be there. We know that there is sound check, so have a nice time and keep watching.
Thank you,
see you soon. Ciao.
Spark TV. Metal in action.
So you see, this is a Christophe Capelli guitar, French luthier. And it's wonderful, it's amazing. I have three of them, one white, one black, and one red, colors I prefer. And you see, here you have rosewood, maple woods, no? Eider, here is the Tonzon, here the Air Norton Classic, something like that, for the solos, perfect for my sweet picking technique, the one that I prefer, of course. And yeah, I love it. It's so thin, you see? Like guitar for children.
Spark TV. Metal in action. CDčka, DVDčka a LPčka, trika, mikiny a další věci od Rhapsody nakoupíš na www.sparker.cz.